everybody, Erica Serwin here from Pink Bucker Designs, and today is day 4 of my 12 days of Christmas projects. I am featuring the Regal Reindeer Bundle. If you click the link here on YouTube, it'll take you back to my blog where you will find the supply list, measurements, and a second project featuring the Regal Reindeer Bundle. All right, so we're also using another die, as I'm sure you have noticed. It is the Aspen Tree die. This is a really cool die. It cuts out that silhouette, and I have already done that right here. Just a thick, very vanilla card base, and when you set this on here, really all you have to do is make sure it's straight, because the first one I cut was crooked, and you don't want a crooked one. So just kind of eyeball it, make sure it's straight, and then you've got your trees. So I wanted to create a winter background, a winter sunset background, and so I Googled winter sunset. I mean, I know what a sunset looks like, but you know, I still wanted to see. And all the pictures were pink and purple rather than what in my mind I was thinking orange, yellow. No, they were all pink and purple. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to use blending brushes and we're going to start with polished pink. This is a piece of very vanilla that is just smaller than the card front, about 4 5¼. And I like to start over here on the grid paper first so that I don't get any kind of hard smash marks from my blending brush. And I'm just gonna kind of start from the bottom and move down like this. I want it darker down here on the edge than up here. All right, so now I'm gonna move to Highland Heather. I'm gonna get another blending brush. And we're going to turn it and we're going to meet in the middle. All right, now Highland Heather, I don't know if it's that my ink pad needs to be inked, but it's not quite as potent as that polished pink. But go easy on yours at first. I really do think it has to do with, you know, how juicy your ink pad is. All right, so we're going to kind of run these in the middle. I want really there to be a soft kind of blending of the two. So I'm just kind of going over it, hoping that there's not a real hard, you know, line of where these two colors meet. Get a little bit more. Okay, now, last but not least, I'm going to take Gorgeous Grape. Now, Gorgeous Grape is a very potent, rich color, so you want to go easy. And really, I just kind of want the edges like this. So I'm just gonna kind of, you know, a little bit, mostly the top, maybe fourth of the paper. I want it to be a little bit darker. And you can kind of move down. Ooh, got a little crazy there, didn't I? Let's go back and blend that up. Let me get a little bit more. And you know, you can do this all day long until you get exactly what you want. I think I'm gonna stop here because it does look pretty good. Maybe I need a little bit more Gorgeous Grape up here on the edge. All right, there. I'm pretty happy with that. So you can leave it like this, or you can get some water and flick water on it. I like to use water drops to give me a little bit of a, oh, you know, some texture. So I'm just going to take my water painter and just kind of flick. Okay, and I'm going to leave it there, I don't know, like 10 seconds, and then take a paper towel and just dab it. And there you go. Beautiful, isn't it? All right, so we've got our sunset, and we're going to put that behind here with dimensionals. So I'm going to take a dimensional and put in each corner. And you want the pink side, that's where the sun is setting, so it goes on the bottom. And we're just going to adhere that right there like that. Ooh, beautiful. All right, for our reindeer, you're going to want to cut him out of 3 different colors. Let's look at the die here. I've got this die. I've got the reindeer outline also for the stamped images, but we are just going to use this guy. I've also cut this piece and these little tiny dots out of gold foil. You'll see that in a second. So we're going to paper piece this guy, which means we're going to take pieces of different colors and piece it all together. So I am going to cut out just like this chest part right here from him. And there's already some little cut lines, so it's not too hard. So just kind of take your scissors and follow along where those little cuts are, and then snip it off. And then I just kind of went straight across his neck like that. Okay, and then I'm gonna take just a tiny bit of Tombow liquid glue and adhere that, matching up those cut edges like that. Okay, now let's see if I can get that lined up a little bit better. There we go. Now for the antlers, I'm going to cut them off of the crumb cake piece, just straight across. And so that I don't have to match up all of those pieces, I am going to cut off a lot of it. Okay. And then we'll just go over here, just dot, 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 very, very little. Okay. And then line that up with those. Like that. Okay, so there's your paper pieced reindeer. You don't want the espresso antlers to show. So really wiggle it around until it's all covered up. There we go. All right, now for the gold harness, I put an adhesive sheet on the back of my brushed metallic cardstock before I cut it out. So it's now a sticker. And we are gonna put this on like this, and you just kind of have to wiggle it around until you see exactly where it matches up, like that. Now these are a little bit harder, and if you would prefer to use liquid glue on these, of course you absolutely can, but if you take your pig tool, it helps to scrape off the backing of the adhesive sheet. And these are just tiny little ornaments that I'm going to put on his antlers. All right, so I hold it down with my fingernail, take your pick tool and peel that off. It's like surgery. Let's use our scissors to hold it down. Once you get it going, it normally just comes right off. There we go. That one right there, and we'll do one more. Let's turn that over. They're just teeny tiny, but they're so cute. I really think that they are worth it. Okay, put that one up here. All right, now all we need now is a strip of very vanilla, and we're gonna stamp on Peace on Earth on the left side. And I think that my piece is too thick, so let's cut it down. I think it really needs to be about 3/4 of an inch. There we go, that's much better. Strip of very vanilla, and we'll bring back our card. And we're gonna put this across with two dimensionals, just right there across the bottom. And then we'll take our adorable reindeer, one dimensional will do, and we'll put him right there. Now look at the difference of the intensity of my ink. Oh, and I did it upside down, didn't I? I said to put the pink at the bottom, and I did the exact opposite of what I did. You know what? Let's see if we can flip that around. Yep. My ink is still kind of wet, so the dimensionals aren't sticking real well. And we can fix it. There we go. That makes much more sense. All right, you guys, make sure you click the link here on YouTube. Go over to my blog. Check out the other Regal Reindeer project. And let me know if you have any questions. Thanks, everybody. Bye-bye.